since we are coming to the close, I would request one short question, and I would request the speaker also to give a short reply. Please come.
My profession is training in yoga and public speaking skills. I am Chandra Kumar. Yeah, good evening, my dear soul friend Jake Naik. Just one thing. I am basically Hindu, and I have equal respect for all other systems also, and I could learn some techniques of Christianity and Islam from my father also. Fine. So I would like to know from you, and in other systems, all are not universal, only for particular community and particular segment. Islam, but the Quran is for, you are telling Surya Subha 24-28, some difference for universal thing. Fine. The crisp of the Vedic, I mean, to the best of my knowledge, it is Sarve Janaha Sukhino Bhavantu. Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinaha, it says. But it doesn't say Sarve Hindu Sukhinaha, Sarve Hindu Sukhinaha. No, it is all the human beings should be merciful, happy, and pleasant. It is one thing. And another thing, whatever the you are describing for Allah in Surya Ikhlas, Kulhu Wallahu Ahad Allahu Samallam Melel Valam Yulad Valam Yakullahu Kufuwan Nahad. Like that, in our Vedas also, verses 24 to 28, Samadhipata of Yoga, it is describing Klesa Karma Vipaka Asayahi Aparam Rushnaha Purusha Visheshaha Yishvaraha Tatra Niratisayam Sarvajna Bijam Sarveshama Piguruhu Kalena Aravachedat Tasya Vachakaha Pranavaha. He has not given to any birth to not any person. He was not born to any person. And he is superior to even five basic elements. And he is at all the times omnipresent. That is Ishvara. Whatever the Allah you have given, it is appealing to the same Ishvara, what we call. And in Bhagavad Gita, since you know, Sloka 31 of Chapter 3, I mean Karma Yoga, it says, Yete Matamidam, Yete Matamidam, for Manavaha, Shraddhavayo, Anasuyatom, Muchente Api Karma Bihi. What he says, whoever follows my religion, all the human beings, Lord Krishna says, not only the Hindus who follow, all the human beings who follows my words of Bhagavad Gita, I am with them. That is the thing. And to the best of my mind, I don't know that Sura, you say, Miyamala Miskala
Zarvatina. We are getting late. You already asked three questions already. Please. You have asked one question. The police is saying the time is up. We have to respect the law. Otherwise, they say, I'm not a good Muslim. I got the chit that I have to end by 10:30. 10:30 is already up. I'll just try and reply in brief. All these questions answered on the website. You can go to my video cassettes. I'll give you a copy of Similarity of Islam and Hinduism. The brother said, an answer in short, for more details, refer to my other cassettes. The brother said that even Hinduism says that sukh for all of humanity. Brother, I said that whenever the scriptures came, it came for that time and for those people. That means sukh for whole of humanity of that time. Of that time. Not in eternity. Otherwise, your Hindu scripture wouldn't have said there is a rishi to come. If everything was mentioned in the Vedas, why will the Vedas say antim rishi will come for what? If the Vedas mention all the truth, why will they say one more rishi is going to come for what? So this proves that the Veda did say about human being, but for that time. It doesn't say it for the whole of humanity forever. So all the scriptures, when they say another rishi is going to come, that means he is going to come to say something else. In the Quran it says Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the last messenger. After him, no one will come. If anyone says, I get a wahi, I get a revelation, today he requires a psychiatrist. Messengership is over. Coming to your other question, you said that your Vedas, your second and third question, your Vedas said God is one, you should not worship him, etc. I agree with it. That's what I said. Kulavallavad. So what is the question? But do you worship such a God? You said you believe in Kulavallavad. God is one who is not begotten, who has got no image. There's nothing like him. So I am asking you, yes, I believe in that. Do you believe in such a God? So the moment you give an idol to God, that means it is going against your Veda. And as I mentioned earlier, it's clearly mentioned in the Svetasatara Upanishad, chapter number 4, verse number 19, and Yajurveda, chapter number 32, verse number 3, Natasya Pratima Asti, of that God, there is no Pratima, there is no statue, there is no idol, there is no image, there is no photograph, there is no sculpture. You believe this and worship such a God, like the four criteria of Surah Ikhlas, then you are worshipping the true God, otherwise it's a false God. Hope that answers the question. Wa akhiru da'wana, alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.
Salaam. Salamun.